Hi, everyone. This is Jim Miller saying welcome to the 1988 high school football season. We invite you to join us for the next 30 minutes as we preview teams from throughout northeastern and central Pennsylvania. I'll look at squads in the Wyoming Valley Conference. Sid Michaels will cover teams in the Big 11, and Scott Masteller will profile teams in the Williamsport area. We simply call it High School Football 88. Stick around. I know you'll enjoy it.
Wait.
The 1987 high school football season in the Wyoming Valley Conference crowned a pair of champions who had fought their way back to respectability. The A division was captured by the Tigers of Tunkhannock. The B division champions, the Mountaineers of Dallas.
To get a taste of winning like that, I could see it in a senior's eyes this year. It's a little bit different than I've ever been here. They have a little bit more confidence in themselves, and they know how hard it is to work to get to a championship, because that was a hard-working group of kids last year.
So it was unbelievable. It was a, you know, a high that I think was one of the few things you can experience ever in sports. It was a great feeling for the kids, for our coaching staff, and you know, it was the ultimate of what we could possibly do, and it was fantastic.
The 1987 A Division season in the Wyoming Valley Conference race last year turned out to be the year of the Tiger, the Tigers of Tunkhannock under head coach Tom Ozuweski. The club won the conference championship, knocked off the Bulldogs of Berwick in the semifinals of the Eastern Conference playoffs, and wound up in the title game against the Chiefs of Lakeland.
You think about last year, we won three games last year, 7-6. Our margin of, as far as us being better than anybody in the conference, isn't that great. I think our kids realize that, and they have to work harder to hopefully improve our margin. Those close games last year did a lot of good for our team as far as getting confidence.
For the Warriors of Wyoming area, last year was a year of experience. Under first-year head coach Frank Parra, they finished 3-7, but with a break here and there, could have easily finished at 6-4. They hope that that experience and lessons learned last year will pay big dividends in 1988.
Last year, we had one experienced football player on the starting units. This year, we're talking about 12 kids who've been on the field week after week last year, and that experience factor, I hope, proves to be a big, big plus for us this year.
The Patriots of Pittston area under veteran head coach Bob Barberi stand a pretty good chance at challenging for a top spot in the A division in the Wyoming Valley Conference race this year. Last year, a lot of young kids got plenty of playing time in a season which produced an overall record of 3-7.
We're very happy. I think we got key people coming back in the line because we played so many sophomores last year. Four starters coming back, and we got our quarterback back, who I think is probably going to be the best in the conference, and we got some good receivers, so we're optimistic. We are hurting for running backs, and we're making some changes of skilled people who played other positions, but I'm very optimistic at this point.
1987 was a disappointing season for the Crusaders of Coughlin. They finished under 500 with a record of 4-6. One of the priorities going into 1988 for head coach John Joseph, find a quarterback to replace Russ Mashinsky.
We got some great linemen coming back, you know, kids who played an awful lot for us. Last year we were young, and we played the beginning of the year like we were young, you know. We ended up with a 4-6 season last year. So we're looking to improve and have the kids show their experience they learned last year and have a better start this year.
1988 will definitely be the year of change for the Spartans of Valley West as they welcome a brand new head coach in Bill Chase, who hails from Elizabethtown, Pennsylvania. Chase replaces veteran head coach Jim Fennell. He looks forward to this opportunity, having a football team that he can now call his very own.
I think the system will fall in by itself as the weeks go by. I think the personnel is important right away. I don't know a lot of the kids. I had about 9 or 10 kids at the Stroudsburg team camp, and I got to know some of them there. I'm pleased with some of the positions that we have, and I know some of them. But other than that, you know, I'm going to have to depend on my assistants, who I think are going to do a good job, and we're going to have to pick out the kids that are going to be ready to play.
Critical injuries and inexperience forced the Mountaineers of Hazelden to struggle last year. They finished with an overall record of 2-9. However, the coaching staff feels that the experience gained by the young personnel will reap benefits in 1988.
Playing time is the key ingredient to experience, and no matter how many seniors you have on a football team, if they didn't play the previous year as juniors, you know, they're not an experienced group. We have an experienced group where we have a little more depth with experience, and we have an explosive quarterback, Ricky Morelli, who we feel is as good as any quarterback in the conference this year.
The Bulldogs of Berwick finished their 87th season on the goal line in a tough loss to the Tigers of Tunkhannock in the semifinals of the Eastern Conference Championships. It's a new season and a new team. Same veteran head coach in George Curry, and you can bet that the 88 Bulldogs will be ready.
Again, it's how fast our young people get confidence, how fast they learn our system, and the mental attitude, if we can win early, you know, you just play a little better. With every win, you play a little bit better, and this is what we're hoping happens.
The Trojans of Nanticoke, under head coach Bill Goodman, enjoyed a pretty good season in 1987, posting an overall record of 6 wins against 5 losses. The key factor going into 1988, finding a replacement for quarterback Jim McDermott.
Yes, we got some new coaches, a lot of new faces. I'm thrilled about it. You know, we're all excited down here. A lot of new people getting to see. A lot of fine athletes graduating, and it's a whole new offense, whole new defense. It's fun.
The story in high school football in 1987 was the year of the Mountaineers of Dallas. Under head coach Ted Jackson, the club won the Wyoming Valley Conference Class B Championship and the Eastern Conference title. 1988, the big question, what can you do for an encore?
Well, the first thing we got to do is forget about 1987, because that's not going to do us any good this year. So we have to forget about last year, and we got to work real hard, just like we worked last year, and try to develop a team attitude like we had before.
On the first day of training camp last year, the question at GAR was finding someone to replace Greg Skrepnak. 1988, different problem. Finding a quarterback, someone to replace John Snyder.
We lost our entire offensive line and part of our backfield, losing John Snyder and Leroy DeGraffenried in backfield as well. So we're going to be rebuilding this year. We're going to go with a lot of underclassmen. Some underclassmen had experience from last year, but we're still going to be quite green around the ears for a while. And I think after a while, we'll be okay. We'll be GAR of old before too long.
Myers High School football will have a distinctly different look in 1988. Gone are the Ismaels. Rocket to Notre Dame, Cardew to Syracuse. Mickey Gorham has retired as head coach. The new man is Rich Chaconis. He looks forward to a new campaign.
We didn't give up everything. We kept what we felt the boys can handle. What we felt, because of the inexperience on hand, we try to maybe make it a little more simplified. We did keep things, but on the other hand, we did change. We changed a little offensively. We changed a little on the defense.
The Hawks of Hanover area have enjoyed outstanding success in the 1980s, back-to-back Eastern Conference championships under head coach Alex Kopasz, and 1988 should be no different. This team will be ready to go from day number one.
We don't have as many returning people back as a lot of other people think we do. I think there's been a lot of talk that maybe Hanover is going to be the favorite in the B division. We have actually only 6 players back that played for us last year, but those six are right among the top in the entire league, we believe. You know, what we have to do is get a good supporting cast to go around them.
1987 was indeed the year of transition for the Comets of Crestwood. They finished with a record of 2-8 following their championship Class B Eastern Conference season of 1986. Head coach Bill Jones and company hope that 1988 will be much better.
Well, we're optimistic, Jim. We're not a very big club physically, but we probably have more speed than we've ever had up here. So we're going to find out, you know, what's more important, size or speed. We're very quick, very fast, but size we're lacking.
It was a team that was 5-5 in 1987 and a club that approaches the 1988 campaign with a tremendous amount of confidence. They are the Black Knights of Lake Lehman under head coach Rich Gorgone.
Well, I think our main goal since we've been back was to become a very competitive football team, and I think we did that. I think we could compete with anyone on our schedule. And now our goal this year is to try to take a step beyond that, you know, like toward a championship.
The Argents of Bishop Hoban look to continue the winning tradition built under head coach Sal Montagna over the last several years. Their record in 1987, 6-3-1. The question mark going into 88, find replacements for 11 graduating seniors.
Well, we got a lot of experienced people this year. We got six starters on offense, back six starters on defense, and we got some very good skilled people this year.
What did those kids learn last year during a most competitive season that's got to help you this year?
Well, I hope they learned enough to win a championship this year. If we can keep healthy, I think we can be right in the championship hunt this year.
1987 was a year of adjustment for the Queensmen of Bishop O'Reilly. The football program had to get used to a brand new coach and coaching staff, and they finished a 10-game schedule with an overall record of 2-8.
We look for a much better year this year. We have a lot of experience. Our quarterback's back. We have some key people on the line. So we're hoping that we can be much more competitive this year.
The 1987 Big 11 high school football chase crowned a pair of champions that used tremendous speed and outstanding power. The A division was captured by the Lakeland Chiefs, the B division by the Cavaliers of Scranton Prep. For a look at 1988, here is Big 11 reporter Sid Michaels.
A year ago, head coach Dan Case led his talented Lakeland Chiefs team to an undefeated season and the Eastern Conference Class A Championship when they defeated Tunkhannock in the title game right here at Chapman Lake. If the Chiefs are to repeat in 1988, there will be some big spots to fill, especially those left vacant by the graduation of three talented offensive backfield performers. The Chiefs will have to do without the explosive backfield trio of Joby Fawcett, Ed Dokolovich, and Paul Pigeon.
I don't think we had, let's say, anybody that was quite as quick as Joby. I think our backs have good quickness. Our quarterback, probably Blaine Fawcett, he will be quicker than Paul Pigeon was. And he's throwing the ball pretty well right now. So we're happy with their progress. We have a long way to go, but as long as they keep improving, I think we'll be all right.
Up front, the Chiefs are huge. They average well over 225 across the line.
Yeah, we have size. We have size. We lost four of our five starting offensive linemen, though. And that size, hopefully, will compensate for a little bit of lack of experience.
A year ago, the Scranton Prep Cavaliers went 11-2 on the season and advanced to the Eastern Conference Championship game, where they came up short against the Dallas Mountaineers. In 1988, head coach Phil Angeli not only is missing a lot of key players from that team, he's also missing some size.
We have quite a few kids in the range of 170 to 195, but nobody into the big as a starter right now, anybody into the 200 pounds. So we're really light.
Coach Angeli's got to replace his entire starting backfield, and that's one of the things they're working on heading into the season.
We don't have anybody big enough to get that strong running game that we had going for us in the past, so we're going to try to put the ball in the air a little bit more.
If there's one spot West Scranton head coach Joe D'Antona doesn't have to worry about in 1988, it's quarterback. Peter Iacobazzi returns after an impressive junior season. While Iacobazzi returns at the quarterback position, there are some other big holes to be filled in this Invader offense. Running backs Donnie Monticelli and Nick Stelmack have graduated, as well as the Invaders' top receiver from a year ago, Jerry Capp.
We're looking for at an awful lot of kids and trying to fill an awful lot of positions. And if it means moving kids around and playing positions that they hadn't played before, that's what we'll do.
While Cy Dewaihe has some talented people in the backfield at Scranton Central, his concern is up front, both offensively and defensively.
Some of our younger people, I think, probably as the season goes on, will be able to step in and start to play well. But the inexperience and the lack of size, we're really not big.
At Scranton Tech, head coach Bill Tonkin is bubbling over an offensive backfield that returns four solid performers.
Mike Marichak will be handling the quarterback spot. We're going to be running a lot more option game, and Mike does that very well. And we've got Lloyd Blackwell, Brooke Holzman, Nate Williams, and Kelsey Simmons running the football.
With those horses in the offensive backfield, the points will get put on the scoreboard for the Scranton Tech team. The question is how quick a young front line will mature. A young, inexperienced team will be taking the field at Valley View in 1988. Head coach Frank Bazalia lost a lot of players to graduation, including all-scholastic running back Randy Cordish. Overall, the Cougars returned just six starters from 1987's team.
We really have only three veterans coming back on offense and three on defense. So we do have a lot of experience. We do have a lot of kids that need some experience. So we're hopefully in our scrimmages, we'll get a little work and some of these youngsters might develop.
Valley View will have more size than a year ago, but less experience.
We are probably a few pounds heavier per man this year than we were last year. Of course, last year we were very, very small up front. This year, I think some of our youngsters are a little bigger, lacking a little, experience, which we're going to have to develop real quickly.
Those growing pains may also be felt here at North Pocono, where head coach Nick Donato has to replace up to four members on either the offensive or the defensive front lines. The Trojans' success could depend on how fast line replacements mature, since in offense, the skilled position players are talented.
We had Brad Smith returning. He rushed for 11 touchdowns last season. Brian Kelly rushed for over 400 yards. They're two excellent sprinters, so we have a great deal of speed. We have Dave Smith to go along with him. This is Dave's, he's going into his junior year. He started a couple games as a freshman, and he was our starter last season. So we're looking for those kids to fulfill their potential.
Defensively, North Pocono will have to guard against the big play, which hurt them badly a year ago.
Consistently, teams didn't nickel and dime us, but they made the big play against us, and our pass defense hurt us last year. Now, we have, again, some experience back there, so I hope we've learned from what's happened last year in the secondary. I think I'm more concerned, especially in our league, too, with stopping the run.
At Riverside, head coach Hank Butcher's main concern is finding a new quarterback. Gone because of graduation is signal caller Glenn Kempa, and those are some pretty big shoes that Butcher will have to fill. If Riverside finds a suitable replacement for Kempa, this offense could put big numbers on the scoreboard.
We have a big backfield this year. We had Corby and Johnny Starts and Klimas and Mike Gunn. And this year will be more run-orientated. But then again, we still have the two best receivers of the Big 11, and Johnny Connell, who had a great year for us last year, and Jody Simone, who got hurt early in the season. He's back.
Some talent on defense could also help the Vikings improve on their 5-5 record of a year ago.
Brian Majeleski is back at defensive end, and we're trying two new kids to tackle, and D'Angelo is good size, and his younger Novak boy. So we have good size up front and the defensive front also.
At Dunmore, head coach Jack Hanses is young and talented. The question is just how quickly those young players can get that experience.
Well, our biggest difficulty is being our defensive line and our inside linebacker. We lost some great kids last year that had a real great speed, so we've got our work cut out for us. On the offensive standpoint, we got the only one we have coming back is our offensive center. We've got a young line, and we have to do some hard work with those young people.
Abington Heights returns one of the top rushers from last year in the Big 11 in Billy James, but head coach Ray Ronke has some big shoes to fill as he has to replace quarterback Steve Krauntz.
Jamie Steyer has to take the place of Steve Krauntz. Steve gave us 3 years as a starter. We're going to miss Steve, no doubt. But Jamie's a very hard worker, and he's a very dedicated kid, so hopefully his hard work and dedication will compensate for a lack of experience.
Overall, the Comets will be young, and they may be a year away from some big things.
We have about five sophomores starting and seven juniors, okay, and just a handful of seniors. And again, hopefully they're going to mature early and hopefully gel early.
For the past 6 years, it's been our privilege and pleasure to showcase high school football in the Williamsport area, and 1988 is no different. Back for his fifth consecutive season on the Scoreboard Show and looking at prospects this time around, here is Scott Masteller.
At South Williamsport, optimism is very high as the Mounties get ready for the 1988 season. South finished 1987 with a record of 6-5. Head coach John Zalona says after a slow start last year, the team matured near the end of the season, and that should carry over to this year.
We had a lot of younger kids playing for us last year. We started seven sophomores, and most of them were skill position people, our quarterback, our wideouts, and a number of people up front. Towards the end of the year, we started to throw the ball very, very well, and I think we're going to pick up right there again this year, and we're going to throw the ball a little bit more than we run this year.
The Mounties open their season Friday, September 2nd at Warrior Run.
The Williamsport Millionaires are known for having one of the more successful high school football programs in central Pennsylvania. This season, head coach Tim Montgomery welcomes a team that will have a definite size advantage over many of their opponents.
That advantage may be hampered somewhat by a lack of experience in the all-important skill positions.
You make sure.
However, Coach Montgomery feels this year's team is one that can get better as the season progresses.
I don't think we're going to start off as strong as we did in the last couple of years because our skill people helped us early. So we're going to just have to go by year until we get into the season a little more, and hopefully the kids will progress and get better as each game goes on.
Williamsport opens its campaign Saturday, September 3rd, hosting Steelton. At Loyal Sock, the last 2 years have not been the best. This year, things are looking up for head coach Ken Robbins. The Lancers feel they have plenty of experience returning, plus some good upcoming sophomores that can contribute to the team. As the Lancers get set for their season opener against Lewisburg, Coach Robbins has one goal in mind for this team.
Well, I'd like to win the West Branch Conference. I really would. This is my 20th year, and you know, I think we had some good people, and we're not bragging. I'm not putting any pressure on. I've talked to them about we should have a good football team.
For the Lancers, and really any other team that wants to win the West Branch Conference title, the road to victory usually has to pass through this stadium, which is home to the always tough Montoursville Warriors. Jim Bergen returns for his second season as head coach of the Warriors. Montoursville, 12-1 in 1987, welcomed 7 returning lettermen on offense and defense. According to Bergen, the Warriors, a ball control team, will run their offense a little differently this year.
Well, we always run more than we pass, but I think we're going to try and balance things up more. I said that last year, and the quarterback was able to throw the ball into play-action passes, but we definitely are going to throw the ball more this year.
The Warriors coaching squad is confident they will have a very competitive team by the end of the regular season. Reporting from Williamsport, Scott Basteller, Eyewitness Sports.
Well, there it is, a 30-minute preview of teams from throughout northeastern and central Pennsylvania. For photographer-editor Mark Albrecht, photographers Mike Remplevich and Tim Burke, along with reporters Sid Michaels and Scott Masteller, this is Jim Miller saying thanks so very much for watching and enjoy the upcoming 1988 high school football season.
Get those people. Stop. Head up.
Head up. Always ahead.